a series called Do Something, where we're talking all about injustice. We've said that injustices are the things in our world that are unfair, unequal, or not right. So when we see someone bullied at school for the way they look or talk, that's an injustice. Making assumptions about someone based on the color of their skin, that's an injustice. Students that go to sleep hungry and don't have enough to eat, that's an injustice. People stuck in a lifetime of poverty, also an injustice. Injustices are the kind of things that happen when they happen to make us stop and say, wait a minute, that's not right. Somebody should do something about that. Some of us know injustice because we've seen it. Some of us know injustice because we've heard it. And others of us, well, we know about injustice because we've endured it. Maybe that's you. Maybe you were here last week and thought, so we need to see injustice before we can do anything about it. That's great and all, but what about me? I'm living in the middle of injustice. It's happening to me. What am I supposed to do? If that's you, I want you to remember a few things. First, know that God is with you. He hears you. He made you in His image, and that means no matter what injustices you're experiencing, you have value, you have worth, and you are deserving of respect. And God doesn't want you to walk through what you're experiencing all alone. Second, share what you've experienced. If you're experiencing injustice right now or dealing with an injustice that's happened to you in the past, I'm glad that you're here because we want to be a part of this. We want this to be a safe space for you to process that. We want to be people to help stand up and stand beside you. Maybe for you, that means sharing it with God in prayer and asking for Him to remind you that you're not alone. And the third thing, keep going. If you're experiencing an injustice, I want you to do something. Maybe that something is opening up to an adult. Maybe that something is standing up for yourself. Whatever it is, take a step to keep going. No matter what the injustice is, if you've experienced it, then you know how unfair and painful and hurtful it feels. And you're not alone. Everyone, open your eyes and look around. So many of us here have experienced injustice in one way or another. So many of us have gone through something that's not fair or right. Before we go on, I want to say this. You don't deserve the injustice that you've experienced. All the way back to the very beginning when God created the first man and woman, God tells us we are humans. We, humans, have value because we were made in His image. Because we were made in His image. And because of that, you have value. Nothing will ever change that. You were made to be treated with respect. Those injustices that you've experienced, they say a lot more about the brokenness and hurt in the people who are putting you in that position than they do about you. And with that being said, let's take a look at some people who experienced injustice in the Bible together. In ancient times, there was a king who was pretty crazy, and he was named Nebuchadnezzar. This powerful guy had conquered and captured God's people. And let's just say he was used to getting whatever he wanted. So he decided to build a giant statue over 90 feet tall made of pure gold and told everyone they had to worship it when the music played. And if they didn't, they would be thrown into a blazing fire. Well, there were three Jewish leaders named Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These guys worshiped God, and because of that, they refused to bow down to that statue. The king ordered that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego be captured. He gave them one more chance to bow down and worship when the music played, or they would be thrown into that fire. But even in the face of punishment, these three men stood their ground and refused to worship anyone other than their God. So of course, the king was in full rage mode and ordered them to be thrown into the blazing fire. Just like that, the three men were tied up and thrown in. The flames were so hot that the soldiers who threw them in died just from being next to the heat. What happened to Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego wasn't fair. It wasn't right, and it certainly wasn't something they deserved. So what happened? Now, we're not entirely sure who was in the fire with these men. Was it God? Was it Jesus? Was it an angel or someone else? I don't know, but one thing is clear. God did not allow them to be alone in their situation. We don't have to experience these hurtful injustices alone. In other words, when you experience justice, you don't have to face it alone. In fact, Jesus demonstrated that when He came to earth, He could have come as a king or a powerful person, but instead he came into this world as a baby. He came as a person to experience everything that we experience. Scripture tells us that he knows exactly what we went through. He goes into the fires and injustices right beside us so that we don't have to do it alone. When you experience injustice, you don't have to face it alone. Of course, there's another character to this story, King Nebuchadnezzar. Now, of course, none of you have been throwing people into raging fires because they won't worship a statue of you. But if we're honest, we could admit that we've participated in an injustice against someone else. Maybe we're more like the people in the crowd in this story. We just stood by and watched as this happened to someone else. We didn't speak up or speak out. Maybe for you, that was laughing along when your buddy told some racist jokes. Maybe standing back while somebody got bullied in school. Maybe you were the bully, listening to music that disrespects women, making fun of the girl who can't afford new clothes. If that's you, I want you to know this. Just because you've been that person before, doesn't mean you have to stay that person now. You can change. Maybe the best step you can take against injustice is to make the change to be the person who doesn't contribute to injustice. You can talk to God about that too. You can ask him to help you see the places that you've participated in this. You can ask him to give you the courage to make it right. And maybe once you find the courage, you can become the person in the crowd who's brave enough to speak up and speak out when someone's about to experience that injustice. You can be the voice that stands up to injustice when you see it. Remember, when you experience injustice, you don't have to face it alone.